All right, everyone. We are back for our second segment of Queens of the Trenches Tuesdays on No Line, No Shine. And I'm super excited to have our next guest on. Personally, I would not want to be lined up against her on the other side of the line. I'd be terrified. But I'm super excited to get her perspective on football and to have her be part of the show. So as soon as she hops in here, we will definitely get her live. Oh, thank you for the love, Miss Purplelicious 1002. I appreciate it. Super excited to see everyone live and here joining us. And there is our next guest. And as soon as she sends a request, we will get her in here. And I see Dee has got all the love already in the chat. I love this. This is awesome. All right. So here we go. There she is.
Yo, yo. No Line, No Shine Nation.
Yes, I definitely want to give you the proper introduction. So, Dee Warner, defensive tackle from the Mississippi Panthers. IG handle Queen Kong 44, which I love, by the way.
Yes, ma'am.
I was watching some of your film, and I was like, I don't want to be against her. I don't want to be on the other side of the line.
No. Oh. I hear that so much.
I love it. So all your teammates are already in the chat, and they are just showing you all the love. We got
Let's go, Panthers.
Yep. We got One True Destiny throwing up those blue hearts, Miss Lady Panthers. I love it. So your team is already all up in this. Like,
yes.
I love seeing that. This is awesome. Like, you... This is
we
great.
Have so much love on this team. Oh, my God. Like, the stuff we've been through to get to the season and then the stuff we've been through during the season, it's just like, it's making us stronger. And everything is starting to come together at the right time, as you can see.
I love it. I think it's awesome. Your team is just Panthers, Let's Go, Timeless Beauty, 27, Diva Guru, 13.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
All of it.
I see them all. Oh, yeah.
Right? This is so great. I love it. Even Dom's, like, his family's from Ruleville, Mississippi. So, yeah, you got all the love here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Mississippi love.
This is great. Queen Kong. And I do love your IG handle name. I think it's such a good name.
I just came up with that just like, what is something that I can relate to that basically is me on the field? And I was just like, you know, they got King Kong, so why not be the queen?
Boom. And you know what? Watching your film, I went on your IG, and, like, it's true. Like, you barrel through people. You really do.
I mean, I lift weights. Somebody better get in the gym.
I love it. You know, with the teammates I have,
I have to stay prepared at all times. They push me, I push them. We're always at each other's necks. Like, RJ is a creative player. So if I'm going to play on RJ's team with Locke and Edwards, and then I got Sistrunk, I got Jackson, I got so many just threats on offense and defense that, man, I don't want to get caught in the loop being behind. No.
That's fair. How long have you been playing now?
This will be my second year, but my first year in the WNFC. I played 1 year for the Mississippi Royalty of the WFA, who are now the Mississippi Monarchy now.
Okay. Awesome. And what really led you into football? How did you kind of stumble into this?
I've always been a lover of football. It's been a part of my family since I was like, maybe five. My dad was a football player and a coach. He's a principal. My brothers, they play. Cousins play. Like, it's just, we're a football family. Like, we get together on Sundays and we're going at it like, no, your team suck. No, my team suck. And we're just back and forth all the time. So, football's always been a part of my life. Ray Lewis has always been, like, my favorite player. So, anything that has him in a video clip, I'm hooked on it. So, it's just been with me.
Nice. So it's been a vibe from day one, basically.
Yeah.
Love it.
Definitely a vibe.
So I'm
Like,
guessing you're
I study
pumped
and I
with you.
study and I study.
Yeah. And that's the thing, especially as a young kid, like being around that, being grown up in that, like it's no wonder that you were on the field, you were in cleats, you were in pads. Like that was just destined to happen. And I'm sure your family is super pumped that you're
Oh
playing.
yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. My dad just, he's like, I always knew you was gonna be a middle linebacker, but I didn't know you was gonna be a D tackle. He's like, oh, so you wanna be me now, huh? And we just go at it all day Sunday. It's just, that's us. Like, I told him that, you can look at the games on your phone, and like, my dad is not technical savvy at all. So when I told him that, he was like, for real? This is real now. Like, yeah, dad, this is the dream. It's coming to a reality slowly but surely, and I can't wait for it.
Yeah. And, which brings us to a great next question. Where do you want to see women's football go and grow into?
Oh, I want us all to be household names, just like the guys.
I love
Like, I want RJ's name to be okay. When you think of Lamar Jackson, you think of RJ Jackson. You feel me? Like, everybody needs to see this, be a part of it. I don't care if you tell 10 people, 20 people, or just one. Tell somebody about the WNFC because it's gonna be big. Like, I'm so excited to be a part of this. I'm so glad and I'm so thankful that we do have a team here in Mississippi and that the WNFC chose us to be a part of this.
That is awesome. I love hearing that. And I love hearing how it's just a household name, just like it's natural. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna go catch a woman play this weekend. Like,
Yeah, like I heard a couple of fans this weekend. It was just like, I just happened to be scrolling on Facebook and I saw you guys play football. And I'm so glad that I came to see this game. This was a great game, which
yep.
we did have a great game this weekend. And
Yeah,
now we.
I heard that. Congratulations on the win. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It was a hard fought game. Like we put in some work, but
Yeah,
we deserve it.
that's awesome. And you guys have a game coming up on Saturday, which I'm sure you're super pumped for.
Oh yeah, we're playing the Florida Avengers this Saturday.
All right. And how are you feeling going into that?
Oh, Florida, you're on the clock, buddy. Sorry,
Oh,
but
no,
you're on the clock, buddy.
I love it. I love
The
it.
Mississippi Panthers are going to arrive Friday evening, and we'll be ready for you Saturday.
I love it. I
We're
just.
coming. We're coming. We're on the rise, baby. Just
Yes.
like Locke said, we are on the rise.
I love it. I love it. And also, someone shouted out, so that poster behind you is actually of that's this year or that's this season. That's the team. That's the guy.
Yeah, that's our schedule poster. It's got our running back, our quarterback, and I wanna say our safety. Yeah, that's LaShonda Williams, number 45, one of our top safeties.
I can dig it for sure. So, obviously football has been a huge impact in your life with your family, with your dad, with your cousins. Were there any other sports that kind of piqued your interest in high school?
I started out playing softball and I was a first baseman and a third baseman. And
Nice.
I played that up until college, and then I had a bad knee injury once I played my first year in college, so I kind of had to hang that up. And then I played basketball most of my high school career, and then shot put, disc, ran a little bit of track here and there, but I was always into athletics, and it was always a year-round thing for me from 7 years old to about 19.
That's awesome. I love that. And so now you're in football, you've got your second season kind of winding down to an end. Your guys' schedule looks awesome. So playoff bound, I'm guessing.
Oh yeah, we're hoping for it. We're right now the Atlantic Division is kind of a toss up right now. It's everybody's, going crazy, but we're definitely in the running and we're getting people to look at the Mississippi Lady Panthers in a different light. I
And
know
say,
we started off 0-2 and everybody's kind of writing us off,
yeah,
but hey, season's not over yet.
right?
Just like the game's not over until it says 0-0 on that clock.
Exactly. So let's say you guys make it all the way to the championships. What is that one team that you guys want to face off for sure?
The Texas Elite Spartans always have a big target on their back.
Yep.
But me personally, and I'm just gonna say this because there's 20 teams in this league, all 19 of y'all. show up.
I
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
I love it.
Whoever you guys put us up against, Mississippi will be ready.
See, that's a whole vibe though. That is a whole vibe. I'm all for it.
Oh yeah. There's one thing we're taught here in Mississippi. We fear no one. We respect all, but we fear no one.
That is so great. I love your team is just blowing everything up here.
Hey, I love my team. I hope they love me just as much as I love
They
them.
do.
We're
They
gonna
based
tear it
on all
up
the
this
comments.
weekend. Let's eat. Everybody
Yep.
get your plates ready. Let's go.
I love it. I love it. And where do you see yourself, being in football as long as you want to play, as long as you can play, until someone has to wheel you off the field? Like,
They're
what is
gonna have to wheel me off
your
the field, pretty much. But I'm looking forward to like once we get done with playoffs in this season, just getting ready during the off season, training, get my body back in tune, eating better, getting healthier. Thinking about coming back a few pounds lighter, but probably stay in the same position and just dominate. Work on my technique. I am crazy about technique. All I do is study YouTube on D-line techniques. So next year will probably be a way more improved and more powerful D-1er. So if you're scared now, I don't know what to tell you because there's more to come.
See, like I said, I would never be lined up. Like, I would know if I ever got back into football, I'd be like, nope, I see her. I'm good. Take me out, coach. Take me out.
No, don't do that. Don't do that. My whole defense will smell blood. Do not do that.
That's
Don't
fair.
show us fear.
That's fair.
I have a defense that is just so dynamic, man. My offense is dynamic, but that defense is just something else. The way we click, the way we communicate with each other, like the communication is getting better, the offense is getting better, they're communicating with each other better. Everything is just starting to gel. Our coaches is just like it's like home. We're a big family. We get to call each other out. Like I had a coach tell me, "Hey, D, if you do that again, I'm probably gonna knock you out." And my eyes got big, but I was like, "Okay, I respect that. Let me not do that again."
That's fair. And I've watched some film and you guys really just do hunt. Like, it is really just a pack of hunters just out
Yes,
all together.
we are.
Seamless machine.
When that clock starts, we're on the hunt.
I love it.
From
Well,
beginning to end, we're swarming you.
that's awesome. That's so great. And so, I'm seeing all your team just show you all this love, which I absolutely love. Like, I'm scrolling through the comments and they're just all the hearts are coming in and everything. Who are
Oh
some?
yeah, nobody's safe. I see you. Oh yeah, I see that's my D tackle, that's my D end, that's my running back. Oh yeah, that's my offensive lineman, that's my QB.
Got everybody in here.
Oh yeah, that's my linebacker. Oh yeah, I got everybody. Everybody tuned in. I love y'all. I love y'all.
It. So, as a player yourself, you talked about some of your mentors. Who on the team are really just, important relationships and family connections that you've made that you really look up to, or even in the WNFC?
I haven't really met and just made too many connections in the WNFC. I'm just really, starting to get a feel for everything. But team wise, everybody, we all got a good vibe amongst each other. And it's just like when you have leaders like RJ and Jamie Locke, you got Ida Edwards, and then you got so many other dynamic players who just bring some special sauce to this game. Like you got Foe Griffin, you got LaShonda Williams, you got so many, like it's so many names. I could give you my entire roster, and I promise you there's gonna be a bully in every position.
I love it. I love it. I think it's great. I think it's awesome. Like, I can't stop smiling because you have.
Yeah, we're a big family, man. We have an old school coach in Dunn who gives that old gridiron feel. We got the young flavor of Steven Jackson. We got a good defensive coach in Deuce Johnson. Like we're really a homebody team. Like everything is just we're peaking at the right time.
Yeah.
Everybody says in the NFL, like you might start off bad, but when you peak at that right moment and you just catch them by surprise, Saturday,
That's
be
it.
prepared.
That's it.
When you sleep, we'll wake you up.
Oh, they're coming big now.
When you sleep, we'll wake you up. Remember that.
Love it. And what are some messages that you have? You know, obviously football is really becoming a thing in younger generations. You're starting to see a lot of young girls get into football, whether it's flag football, put on the pads. What are some messages that you have for the younger generations that's coming up?
Just don't give up on your dream. If this is what you want to do, nobody said you have to be a cheerleader. Nobody said you have to toss a softball. If you want to be a football player, do the work, keep your dream alive, and stay tuned in your local area. You might look up and they'll look up and have a flag football team on your football team or something. So just look out for it. I'm currently working with my old high school on trying to get a flag football team for the girls in that area too. So
That's awesome.
hopefully it all works out and we can get that going.
Definitely, yeah. Did you want to give them a little shout out? And I don't know,
Shout
keep.
out to Lawrence County High School where it all began.
There we go. Keep get that network. Make that reach big.
Yeah, Cougar. Once a Cougar, always a Cougar.
Make it happen. And one thing that I actually really love, so I was looking at your guys' Instagram page. You guys give free admission to youth who are in sports, which I think is really awesome.
Yes, and we also did a football camp for females, for young girls, ages from like 6 to 18, all ages really. We had a good turnout. The kids, they really listened. They paid attention. They had good, footwork. They played a little 1-on-1 against each other, a little flag against each other, and they really enjoyed it. And I really enjoyed seeing them out there. It was a great day. Like, we have to do that again. We're
Yeah.
definitely going to do that again, and hopefully we can get a bigger turnout than last time.
Definitely, yeah. I think that's a great way to do it. Get back in the community, get back to, you know, the future footballers that are coming up and teach them young so they understand.
Oh yeah, start them young and they'll fall in love with it just like I did.
Awesome. What are some big things that you're looking forward to on Saturday besides the win?
Oh, I need a sack. I want a sack so bad. I want two actually, so I can just do me. But I really want that win. I really want to see my team just show out, let all the emotions go and just play their game. Like, don't think about it, just do. And we're gonna come out with that victory.
That is awesome. I had such a great time talking to you. I'm definitely going to be watching your guys' game on Saturday. What time is your kickoff at?
I think it's at 6 o'clock, if I'm not mistaken.
Perfect. So obviously people can catch you on your Instagram. They can follow your team on their Instagram as well.
Yes, ma'am. You can follow the Mississippi Lady Panthers. You can look them up on Facebook or Instagram. You can look me up on Instagram at QueenCone44. And just follow the WNFC, period. Just the WNFC is they're going places.
Yep.
You gotta follow this league.
Definitely. And I see Diva Guru just challenged you to three sacks.
Three? Okay. I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna try that. I got a little swim move I've been working on. See if it's gonna work.
Right. Perfect. I'm definitely going to be looking for that on tape for
Oh
sure.
yeah.
Oh,
Oh yeah.
pause. There it is.
Do so, do so.
That is awesome. Well, thank you so much. I had such a great time talking to you. I'm super pumped for your game. I wish you an awesome game. I wish you a healthy season for you and all your teammates giving you all this love up in here. Definitely shout out to the Mississippi Lady Panthers for just having some real love for your girl. This is
Oh
amazing.
yeah, shout out to the Panthers, shout out to the WNFC, shout out to Cam, shout out to Coach Dunn, shout out to all our coaching staff, everybody that supports the team, all the fans, everybody on the network, everybody on the Viral app, everybody on Vimeo, everybody that supports women's football, No Shine, No Lie, everybody. Thanks for the love.
Thank you. I will definitely reach out to you after your guys' game. I will reach out to you after the season, just kind of see how things go. And who knows, I might be watching you versus the Texas Elite.
Hey, we
Never know.
sure hope so.
Never know. All right.
Hey.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate your time.
No, thanks. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Have a good one. All right. So, first of all, thank you to everyone on the Lady Panthers. The Panthers are definitely in the house. Absolutely. I am so, like, these comments are just amazing. So 100%, 1000% shout out to the Lady Panthers for just blowing up the chat. This is amazing. I love seeing this kind of love. And like I've said in pretty much all of my interviews, women's football really is family. And that's the beauty of it. And that's what you get to see in this thread. You know, this is a beautiful way to actually show it live and true. And so a lot of people can actually understand it. There are some really, really good games that are coming up this weekend that I know I will definitely be watching. I have my eye on you, Lady Panthers. So you have a new fan. I can't wait to see what you guys do for the rest of your season. But that is all the time that I got. That is the episode. I'm super pumped. I cannot wait to have these two ladies both back towards the end of the season, towards playoffs, and then possibly even championships. We will see. I'm Edwina. Thank you so much for joining me on Tuesday's Queen of the Trenches. Thank you so much to my guests today. Thank you to No Line, No Shine, and thank you to the fans. Have a great week, y'all.